Hello Internet and welcome to Ever Wonder Bits. Does the Earth really orbit the Sun? It sounds like an obvious question, but is it? Let's have a look. Here is the Sun and here is Earth. If we set things in motion, our planet revolves around our Sun, so it has to orbit. But don't leave me now. I've got more examples and a surprise. Now, the Earth and the Moon. Please remember that the distance is not true to scale. I want both to be visible within the boundaries of your monitor. Here, the Moon moves around our Earth, but our planet orbits immensely. Still, the Moon is orbiting. Pluto and Charon, or binary star systems, orbit around each other, since their shared barycenter lies in space above the surface of both celestial bodies. But if this barycenter shift is universal and applies to every object with mass, the term orbiting becomes a bit vague. Let's go back to the Earth and Moon. Right now, their shared barycenter is inside the Earth, so our Moon is orbiting. But imagine if our Earth kept its mass but shrunk in diameter. Now we've created a binary system. And at the more extreme end, let's take two misshapen asteroids or elliptical orbits. First, one is orbiting the other, and suddenly they are a binary system, without changing anything. With this, we can now have a little bit of fun. Using this formula, we can calculate the barycenter of two celestial bodies. While d is the distance between the object's centers, ms is the mass of the smaller body, while mb is the mass of the bigger one. Putting in the numbers, we can see that the shared barycenter of the Sun and the Earth is about 449 kilometers away from the center of our Sun. So they wobble around each other, but the Earth is still the lesser partner, so yes, the Earth does orbit the Sun by definition. But, applying the same logic, we have one object in our solar system that doesn't, Jupiter. If we put in the corresponding numbers, we can see that the barycenter is pulled towards Jupiter by around 742,600 kilometers. But our Sun's radius is only 696,300 kilometers. This means the shared barycenter lies in space above the surface of both celestial bodies, turning our solar system into a planet-star binary system. And not by a small margin. Would this turn Jupiter's moons into planets? Not really. Anyway, the center lies roughly 46,300 kilometers above the Sun's surface. That is the equivalent to 9.5 Mercuries, 3.6 Earths, 6.8 Marses, or almost one Neptune. And that's quite astronomical. See you again. Have a good one.